The president also discussed climate change and clean energy during his address to the Australian Parliament. He said the Philippines remains one of the most vulnerable countries to climate disasters, ranking first in the 2023 World Risk Index. He highlighted the need for developed nations to step up and correct the climate injustice.
My administration is committed to accelerating our just, affordable, sustainable, and inclusive energy transition towards carbon neutrality. The Philippines has the potential to be a net carbon sink, absorbing more carbon dioxide than we emit. Yet, we are one of the most climate vulnerable countries in the world, ranking first in the 2023 World Risk Index. This glaring disproportion between our share of responsibility and our vulnerability reflects an injustice that must be corrected. Developed countries must do more, and they must do it now. And as members of the
President Marcos will return to Manila today, but he will be flying back to Australia on March 4th to attend the ASEAN-Australia Special Summit in Melbourne. Some chairs in Terminal 3 of the Ninoy Aquino International Airport have been removed following reports of bed bug infestations. The Manila International Airport Authority says the chairs are being disinfected. That's after passengers complained about being bitten by bed bugs after sitting on the metal chairs in the terminal. Philippine senators are calling for better airport management in light of that incident. Senator Grace Poe urged the MIA to make cleaning and disinfection a regular practice. Senator J.V. Ejercito meanwhile expressed confidence Ramon Ang San Miguel Corporation would prevent the issue from happening again. The SMC leads the consortium which recently won the multi-billion peso contract to rehabilitate NAIA.
Pag si Ramon Ang kasi pumasok, visionary yan, and he gets things done, I think he will make sure that there will be considerable improvement in NAIA right now sa kanyang pag-takeover.
The Philippine Anti-Graft Court junks with finality a civil case against three corporations created through the controversial COCO Levy Fund. In a resolution Wednesday, the court's second division noted the Presidential Commission on Good Governance did not appeal the denial of its motion for reconsideration in 1987. The PCGG accused the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr. and his cronies of diverting the COCO Levy Fund for their personal gains. The funds were supposed to help the Philippines' coconut farmers. The death toll in Gaza surpasses a bleak milestone. The official fatality count is at over 30,000. Gaza's health ministry says around 70% of the casualties are women and children. Israel is facing mounting international pressure to halt its offensive in the tiny enclave. Israel and Hamas have been at war since October 2023 after the Palestinian militant group attacked southern Israel and killed over 1,000 people. Now the Philippine Science and Energy Departments launched the first ever Filipino-made electric boat. The departments held a technical demonstration of a prototype for the SESI e-boat Thursday. The SESI e-boat runs on lithium-ion batteries and can run a distance of up to 2 kilometers or 2 hours when fully charged. It can sail up to 8 knots or nearly 15 kilometers per hour and can service up to 12 passengers at a time.